Hi everyone, just want to do another quick update of something that I've found. I'm going to start the drill press with the cores away, and we're going to look at the baseline power needed to operate it, and it's pretty well 39 watts. So now I'm going to bring the cores back to it and we'll continue. Okay, the cores are in position now. We'll give it a start. Basically, this is a regular generator effect right now that we have. We're delivering not quite 5 watts there, and just under 2 volts. And the power is being reflected back to the prime mover. And now when I short the this side of the coil, the output here is higher, so we're pretty well at 5 watts now. At 2.22 is just a tad under 5 watts, and now our power has gone down by adding that short. So I was then flipping this around and trying it the other way around, putting the load on this side and shorting this coil, and I wasn't getting that effect. I was just wondering, why wouldn't it do the same from this side? And this coil wire length is identical to this coil wire length. When I made them both equal, and I was wondering what is going on. So that prompted me to do more tests, and what I found is somehow this coil here has shorted to the core material here. So if I put my ohm meter from here to the core, I get a continuous, I get a contact. So I can't tell you if that's a positive thing or a negative thing. I just found that yesterday evening, and then I thought, well, I better share that today and see what's going on with that. So the other thing I found as well is, if I leave this core open and I have the load here on load, I've got some pieces of core left here. That was the center of my E that I cut out from my transformer laminations. That was the center part there. So I found that actually, if I just bring this piece here, this chunk of laminations, and just put it there, this does the same as shorting this coil. So I guess I'll give it a start and I'll show you, give you a demo. So right now that piece of core material is brought there. We're under load, and there's our voltage across our load. And if we look at the power consumption, we're at shy of 52 watts. So right now I'll take that out, and if you look, it's gone up to 56 watts. So if I do the short here with the coil, we're down to same thing, about a little higher. It doesn't do it as well. And then if I put the core material, we're down to, so the short plus the core material, we're down to 51.5 watts. And boosted the output on the other side. So now we're exactly at 5 watts. 2.24 volts is 5 watts. And we're exactly pretty well now at 50, somewhere around 51 watts. And I find that kind of interesting, and I thought I would share that. I just took the coil off both now, and it's still, you know, very low. The coil does help a little. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to unwind this coil here and put more protective material. I had some protective tape at the back for the windings not to short out on the core. And I guess I'll have to add more of that. And I'll rewind it, make sure that it's not shorted to the core. And I'll do more tests and see what that effect is about there. So I thought I'd share that. Thanks for watching. Bye now.